In this video, we're going to be building a flex fuel analyzer kit. This will allow you to integrate a GM or Continental flex fuel sensor into your stock fuel system. So the idea is pretty simple and universal. The main thing you need to do is figure out where you want to mount your sensor, and you want to figure out what kind of fittings you need for your stock fuel system. So for my setup, it's going into a 2018 440i. I bought some 6AN line. And then I have some straight fittings that I can use to build that line into whatever length I want. And I got about 3 feet of hose just so I could have a little bit of flexibility in how I wanted to mount the sensor. Then you need 2 female adapter fittings that can plug into your flex fuel sensor. And then you need a male and a female fitting that will adapt your stock fuel system to a 6AN line. And you can kind of see how it works. So one side is dash 6, and the other side is like a regular connection for your fuel system. So this will depend on your car, but you basically need these adapters so that it's easier to integrate it with a regular AN line. Then the last thing you need is your actual sensor and a way to read the measurements. What I'm doing is using a Bluetooth analyzer kit I bought from a member on Bimmerpost called Straight Shot, and he builds these and sells them for a pretty good price, so you can definitely hit him up. He also has an app in the App Store for Androids if you want to be able to download that. You can also buy like the Fuel It kit. There's probably others as well, but that way you can just read it off of your phone and not have a gauge running in your car all the time. You can also buy an actual gauge from, you know, AEM, or a lot of the different aftermarket tuners have flex fuel gauges that they sell with the sensor, so that's an option as well. But I went this route. I just bought the sensor on eBay and then a separate Bluetooth adapter. So this is my engine bay. Like I said, I have a 440i with the B58 engine, and I took all the trim off the back because I had an idea. And sure enough, there's this fuel line, kind of connects from here to here, and it's a perfect candidate to replace and have the flex fuel sensor installed. So originally I was just going to kind of jump into one of these connections, have the male fitting go on one end, the female on the other, and have like a loop, and on that loop I could have the flex fuel sensor. But just replacing that line will be a lot quicker, simpler, cleaner, and also in the future, if I ever want to, I can just splice into that section, add like a T-fitting, and then I can run it out to a fuel rail and have it set up for port injection. So it just seemed really convenient. I wish I had thought of it before. Really, all I had to do was replace one of those male adapters with a female one, and then I can just replace that line. So just a good example of why you want to map out where you're going to do your connections first, because it can save you a lot of time. So I took off the high pressure fuel line. This connects to the line I'm replacing, and I'm going to need to change this male fitting to an AN connection so that I can connect my flex fuel sensor to it. And this is the adapter I bought. This is how it looks when it comes out of the box. And what you're basically going to do is unscrew it, and this piece slides over the line like this. All right. And then you're going to take this part, and it just screws on to it. And this is how it'll look. So you can see it's basically converting it to a perfect AN connection, so you can connect whatever you want. And it actually has a gasket inside of it. You can feel it when you push it on. There's like some resistance because that gasket is completely sealing around the line to prevent any leaks. Now, if you do end up going with the loop method, like I was originally planning, you'll need a male fitting. And so this just clips in, you just push it in and it'll clip over that tab. And then it's the same thing on the opposite end. So you can connect whatever AN lines you want. So I've actually removed the fuel line now. This is what it looks like. Nothing too crazy. And this is the new line that I added with a flex fuel sensor in it.
Now, I did have a line that looked just like the one I removed earlier. I'll show that now. But what ended up happening is this bend is too sharp for that thick of an AN hose. So I added this loop at the back just to give me that flexibility I needed to plug it into both sides. So that's why it looks a little more complicated than you'd think it needs to be. If you're able to find like higher quality hose that will flex easier, then you can probably run the shorter route. And then right in the middle, you see the actual flex fuel sensor. And at the bottom, you see the connector for the Bluetooth analyzer. I flipped it down just for clearance. I didn't want it sticking straight up. And then this gray wire that you see is what the actual Bluetooth analyzer is running on. So we already have a wire going from the DME box all the way back to the cowl. And I basically just zip tied it along that length so that it'll run the same route. And then I have the Bluetooth analyzer tucked back here. This is all covered up when everything's together. But this is the Bluetooth analyzer from Straight Shot. This is the fuse box that I use to get power. So I just have an add-a-fuse in there. Unfortunately, it won't close all the way with that fuse sticking up. So I just kind of have it clipped down like this. And then this is where I've got a ground. There's a stud sticking out. And I just have a box of loose bolts and fasteners and stuff from previous projects. And I found a nut that fit on it. So I put a nut on that stud and use that as a ground. But really, anything will work that you can find back in that area. And that's pretty much it. It's that simple. The only thing I want to say for sure, make sure you check for fuel leaks. I had a fuel smell after like a day or two, and it might take a little while for the fuel that you dripped or, you know, got in the engine bay to burn off. But if it lasts for a while, take everything off, check your connections, and just make sure there aren't any leaks.
Mine was leaking right at this connection, and I realized I was probably not paying as much attention as I should because it was hard to tighten it around this hose. So I got everything out of the way, got a box wrench on there and really tightened it down, and my fuel leak went away. So just do your due diligence, make sure everything's good, and you won't have any problems in the future. So at this point, I've been using it for a couple weeks. I'm actually on fully 85 now, no issues, and enjoying it. So I highly recommend this mod for anybody that just wants to be able to check their ethanol percentage on the fly. All right. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below.